St. Lucia is absolutely gorgeous, but is staying at the Sandals property here in St. Lucia worth it? Stay tuned because I'm going to show you all the ins and outs of the resort, from the food, the rooms, the beach, of course, everything we always do in our all-inclusive resort reviews. Is it worth it? Is the hype of the Sandals name worth it? I'm going to be brutally honest with you in this video, so I hope you Sandal fans are ready for it.
What's up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I am bringing you something totally new. We are in a completely different area in the Caribbean. We are down on the beautiful island of St. Lucia reviewing an all-inclusive resort with you guys. Most of you know I love Mexico and sticking to that area, but we're ready to branch out and bring you some more all-inclusive resorts to review. Now, as always, I'm going to be 100% honest with these reviews. What's the good? What's the bad? The pros, the cons, everything about the resort to help you decide, is it really worth your hard-earned money? So definitely follow me along as I show you this gorgeous resort and tell you my true thoughts and opinions. Definitely hit us up if you're ready to book something. You know we've got you covered with all of that. So if you're new to the channel, we're a young, fun couple that likes to keep it real and have a good time. My husband's a travel advisor, I'm a hairstylist, and we love bringing you these all-inclusive resort videos. So definitely subscribe and let's jump right into this resort review. Now, to be perfectly honest, I've always thought Sandals was an overpriced resort brand, but there's not a whole lot to choose from on the island of St. Lucia when it comes to all-inclusives that had everything that I wanted. So I thought, what the heck, let's give it a try, see what it's all about. I'm gonna let you know the full breakdown of this resort, from the beaches, the rooms, the food, the drinks, everything that I always include in my resort reviews. And I also include some fun excursions that we did that might be appealing to people who are traveling here to St. Lucia. So stay with me, I'm gonna break it all down. You can look at the timestamps and fast forward if you're wanting to look at a certain thing about this resort, but let's get started. So after a long flight, or what I thought was a long flight from Texas, we finally arrived to a very, very small airport in St. Lucia. We did choose to go with a helicopter transfer to get to the resort. More breakdown on that in just a second. Now, when you book through Sandals, you do get their lounge access. You get a private lounge to wait for your transfer. Your free transfer is included with your Sandals reservation, which is awesome. However, I heard some really bad experiences of taking a transfer through the windy mountains, people getting sick, so we chose for a helicopter transfer. Now, when you look up Sandals in St. Lucia, you'll notice that they have three different resorts. The first one is Sandals Halcyon. It is the smallest out of the three. It's more chill, quiet. So if that's your vibe, then you might love this property. However, it was a little too quiet in the reviews for me. The next one is La Talk. They have two different sections, one on the side of a mountain, the other one is on a beach. However, the beach was a lot rougher, I heard, and I just love a calm, nice beach. So that's why we ultimately went with Sandals Grand. I also heard the entertainment was a little bit better, but it's definitely a further drive, so definitely keep that in mind. But the cool thing is you can visit all of these properties no matter which one you're staying at. They do have free shuttles that will run you to each resort. So now let's jump back to the helicopter transfer. This was $190 per person, a little expensive, but we treated it as an excursion in itself. Our pilot gave us a ton of information about the island. We got to see the pitons up close and the other Sandal properties. It was just so, so neat. And this took less than half the time that car ride would take. And after traveling a long day, you don't want to spend 2 hours in a car, even though it was free. I'm so glad we did this. So once we landed from the helicopter, they had a shuttle waiting for us that took us to our resort. Within 10 minutes, we were there. Not bad at all. And the check-in process was very, very quick. Our room was ready. They welcomed us with drinks and gave us a little information about the property. Now, even though they say this is the bigger resort out of the three in St. Lucia, it didn't feel big to us. It has about 311, I believe, rooms, 19 different room categories, you guys, including overwater bungalows, which were super nice. Of course, we didn't want to spend that money, but they do have them here if that's what you're looking for. You don't have to go to the Maldives to get an overwater bungalow. But overall, this property is gorgeous. There are a few things that definitely need to be updated, especially for how much they charge people to come here. More on that towards the middle of the video, so definitely stay tuned. Now let's start breaking down this property by pools, beach, rooms, food, entertainment, excursions, all that good stuff. If you don't want to watch each individual section, just definitely fast forward through the timestamps to find what you're looking for. So let's start out with the pools, since normally that's where I spend 80 to 90% of my time. The first pool is located at the end of the resort, very, very small and tiny. I guess it's a good place to get away from the noise from the main pool and the DJ. Definitely quiet over here, away from the music if that's your thing. Now the next set of pools are located where the swim-up rooms are. You don't have to book a swim-up room to jump in these pools, but they are technically for the swim-up guests. They give you mats, so that's kind of cool. But if you take a look at these pools, they are really outdated. There's broken tiles everywhere. From above, when you're walking, you have a top room, you can see how outdated these pools are. And for how much they're charging for these rooms just blows my mind, you guys. I mean, they definitely need to update these pools. Now, here's the main pool. This is where we spent basically 60, 70% of our time, other than the beach. Very nice. Again, definitely could use some updating, I feel like, but I loved the bar, how it wrapped around that entire tower. So you never really had to wait very long for drinks. I will say I never saw servers walking around to take drink orders. So you may have to jump out of your seat, go to the swim-up bar, go to the walk-up bar that's beside it. Now, another thing I like when we go to resorts is having a fun pool vibe. Not necessarily a party vibe, but just some fun entertainment. And I do feel like this resort is definitely lacking in that department. Now, I know everyone's different, but it was pretty lame. I mean, the games, it just didn't get the people interacting as much like other resorts we've been to, so it definitely could be improved in my opinion. But again, it might be perfectly fine for you. Over here is the next pool, literally located right by the main pool. They do have a volleyball net here. I didn't really see a whole lot of games going on. And if you follow the top of that pool, it takes you around to another little section with a jacuzzi and another little quiet area for you if you want to escape the music and the entertainment, as they like to call it over there. And that about does it for the pool scene at this resort. Let's talk about the beach. The beach here is absolutely stunning. I love that they have little swings and hammocks in the water for you to chill in. There is some great snorkeling you can do right off of this beach right here. You don't necessarily have to go on an excursion. It's very close to the pools and the bar, so not a far walk for you. And it was just beautiful. I really found myself hanging out here more than I usually do at a resort, especially since the pool scene was a little lame in my opinion, but tons of seating on the beach, nice little beds you can take a quick nap in. And again, we did book our excursions from a local right here on the beach. I always say support the local economy. We'll talk more on the excursions in just a bit, but I did want to show you that they're right there for you to book. It's super easy. We did do some snorkeling right off the beach, saw a sea snake. A couple of them actually totally freaked me out, but they are apparently harmless. They're not venomous. So just heads up, if you're snorkeling out here, you might see a couple of those, but lots of fish. Another cool thing that Sandals offers is not only your water sports that are typically free at most resorts, but they also include snorkeling excursions, scuba excursions if you're certified. If you want to partake in those little mini day excursions, definitely head over here to the water sports desk and sign up as soon as you check in, because they do sell out really quickly with spots. Another thing my husband thought was really neat was he got to wakeboard. They offer skiing and wakeboarding, and it's totally free. I've never been to a resort where they offer this. And it's nice calm water out here, so it makes it great for those type of activities. Now, if you've ever looked at a Sandals property, you will notice that they have so many different room categories available. And like I said, Sandals is expensive. So what we always do typically is get the basic room because we're never in our room. I will say it was nice, it was clean, it had space, but I did feel like I was just in a basic hotel back in Texas. It didn't have that luxury feel to it like most of these all-inclusive resorts have. And we have paid so much less to get so much more at a lot of other all-inclusive resorts. Check out my previous vlogs where we just get the standard room and you'll see what I'm talking about with that. I just like those different type of rooms just to make it feel like you're really on vacation. I just didn't get that feeling here. I mean, again, it wasn't bad. I don't want to knock it too hard, but for what you're paying, they need to get something going on with these rooms because they are just blah, bland, and boring. Definitely need some updating. Even when I was looking at pictures and videos of other room categories, people say, oh, you have to upgrade to get nicer rooms. That's not the case here. I just felt like all the rooms seem to be a little outdated unless you're paying, you know, 10 grand for an overwater bungalow, and we weren't about doing that. So we had a pool view of the swim out rooms. It was very pretty. I do like seeing all the mountains and the lush tropical gardens. It's just some things that they could improve at this location for the price that they're charging people. If they weren't charging the high price, I wouldn't be knocking on them this hard.
Forgot to bring hiking clothes. So got my shoes from the airport, my skort, and a bathing suit top because it's gonna be hot. And Ty's wearing his boots to hike in.
That was super neat. Was right next to our resort was Pigeon Island, a historical site that you can go and hike and get some beautiful
super
views.
Super cute. Totally prepared.
Non-hiking shoes, really slippery.
Totally American.
Right when you walk out. It's a nice little local spot.
I heard so much buzz about this place saying if you're staying at Sandals Grand, definitely walk over and check it out. And I'm so glad we did. There's two peaks that you can hike up to. One's a little easier than the other, but of course we did it without being prepared with shoes and all kinds of stuff. It is a hike though, so bring water with you for sure. There's a lot of history here, a lot of cool forts, little things you can read of what happened back in the 18th century here. So we decided to hike up the tallest mountain first to get that out of the way. And I believe it took us around 20 to 30 minutes after stopping and looking at some things, reading the history, to get up to the very top of the first peak.
Keep up.
Not down.
Sometimes you gotta go down to get up.
Know what they're in for.
Totally. It's steep.
So definitely something I highly recommend you doing. It's such a cheap excursion too. I believe we only paid around $10-$15 a person to do this. It took us a couple hours to do both of the peaks. Go down, read a little bit about the forts and the history of this place. And we did it early morning one day, and we were back at the pool before lunchtime.
Okay, we conquered one mountain. Now we gotta do this one. This one's all paved and easy, they say. You could do this in flip-flops. You don't look steep. That is steep.
Now the next excursion we did was the one that we booked on the beach. This is a combo of snorkeling, going to visit a volcano, and getting all the mud rubbed on you, along with seeing a waterfall. Now it was a little cloudy on this excursion day, but it worked out perfectly because we would have been sweating like crazy if the sun would have been in full blast. We got to see close-ups of the other Sandal properties. This is Sandals Latok. You can see the mountain and the beach resort. Again, I was so glad we chose the because the waves were so rough over here. Then they took us to this spot where they told us was where they filmed Pirates of the Caribbean scene when they were hanging with the ropes. And after doing some research, I came to find that that was incorrect. This is the scene they were talking about in Pirates. They said they filmed a lot in St. Lucia, and this is the actual rock. And it's in St. Vincent, not St. Lucia. However, it was still neat to see, but just in case you did this tour, it's definitely not where they filmed Pirates of the Caribbean. They did take us over to this little lagoon-style inlet where we got to snorkel with tons of fish, the prettiest, clearest water I have probably ever seen to this date. It was so neat. There was so much marine life right here, but we forgot our GoPro, so did not get much footage of the snorkeling. But as you can see, super pretty waters. Then after about 45 minutes, we jumped back on the boat. We went by the Piton Mountains, what St. Lucia is most famous for. Got on the beach to head over to the volcano. Now this volcano that they took us to is supposed to have healing properties in the mud. They told me it would make me look 10 years younger, so I told them to rub that everywhere they could, all over me. You jump in these hot pools, it felt so good. I think they were around like 100 degrees or so. And then after that, we kept the mud and we washed it off in the waterfall right here. So it was a really, really neat tour. They even fed us lunch on the way back, local cuisine. They said none of the crap food from Sandals. This is real Creole food and it was so good. Even though I liked Sandals food, that was pretty good too. So I'm glad we got to try some local food. Then on the way back, they broke out the rum punch, turned on the music. We all had a good time dancing and talking, and it was such a fun excursion. I highly recommend it. So now let's get into the food. Here's a paper they gave us at check-in showing us what restaurants were open on what nights, what they had for lunch. So I definitely wish I would have checked that out before because there's not as many as what I thought there would be here. They also show menus for the other Sandals properties. You can go over there and eat if you want to. We did not. But let's talk about breakfast. The breakfast buffet was not good, guys. Like, I was not impressed at all. I have done so many all-inclusive buffets, and I get breakfast is not anything special or fancy, but it just was not good. There was not a lot of selection in the buffet. Birds flying everywhere, all over people's food. Just did not impress me at all. So when I found out there was an a la carte restaurant open for breakfast, I went over there and tried it out and it was so much better. Highly recommend coming over here for breakfast. It does take a little bit longer to get your food, but if you're not in a hurry, it's a lot better. So I'm not gonna complain much more about the food because everything else was great here. My favorite was going to the Jerk Shack at lunch. I loved their jerk chicken. They had some really cool sides to go with it. You could order hamburgers, quesadillas, all different kinds of stuff, and you had gorgeous views just setting right here. I love eating this way for lunch, right by the pools and the beach, outside without a cover up. If you don't want to sit down at a table, you can always order and take it back to your chair by the pool or beach. We did this one day with nachos. They also have pizza by the pool, and we did try the buffet even after the letdown of breakfast. It was actually really good. But our favorite was definitely sitting by the beach in the pool at the Jerk Shack. So now let's fast forward to dinners. Where did we eat? First, we always hit up the sushi. Especially with it being our first night, we were super tired from all day of traveling, so we wanted something quick. And we chose the sushi bar because you could just walk in, no reservations needed. We got our food fairly quickly. We waited about 5 minutes to be seated and passed our time with the bartender here who made us some delicious drinks. I was drinking lemon drop martinis pretty much every night. But we had spring rolls, all kinds of sushi, some rice, very, very good. Our second night, we were told to definitely go sit outside at the Italian restaurant. The ambience there, the food, everything was so nice. Probably one of my favorites at this resort. And best of all, no reservations required. However, if you do want to sit outside, it is a popular choice. Get there early, especially so you can watch the sunsets. So typically we don't ever do the hibachi tables anymore because we've done them so many times at these resorts. But we were so impressed with the sushi, we decided to get some reservations and try it out. It was really, really good. Then we hit up the French restaurant. This is located right where the breakfast buffet and lunch buffet is. Very, very nice at night though. No bird problems. I got lobster. We got crab cakes. We got some French onion soup. It was delicious. On our last night, we got reservations for the overwater restaurant, Gordon's Steakhouse. It was amazing. I can see the hype here. Of course, setting over the water with the lights really set the mood. It was very romantic. The food was great. Can't say enough good things about this place. I will say, as soon as you check in, head over to the reservations desk and get these reservations made, especially for Gordon's, because we were only here 5 nights. And we were only able to get reservations on our very last night, luckily. I also need to mention a few places you can grab some snacks. One of our favorites was this little cafe here. I forgot what it was called, but you can come get some ice cream, some crepes, little treats. In the morning, you can come get coffee and some donuts and pastries. I hit up this place probably 2 or 3 times a day. The crepes were amazing here. And then, of course, they do have the pub. You can go here for lunch. You can go here for dinner. You can go here for a midnight snack. They do have a few good entrees that you could make a meal out of it, but definitely good for snacking, I thought. So overall, I thought this property had really good food. Now let's move on to entertainment. There was some fun things that went on, but we've definitely had better entertainment at other resorts. But let me break it down and show you what was happening the week we were there. Now, of course, you can go to the billiard room and hang out, play some pool, some darts. We met some nice people here. One night they had a country themed night where a guy came up and sang country songs. They had a little bit of dancing. They tried to have a DJ in the pub after the shows. It just did not work out. No one danced. It was just kind of boring. I would much rather have an actual nightclub where you can go dancing. For the shows, they had karaoke one night. They did have a Broadway show, which was pretty neat. It's kind of small inside, so when they try to accommodate all the guests staying there and putting them all here, you may not get a seat. So if you want to hit up some shows, make sure you're there 20-30 minutes early to get a good spot. My absolute favorite show was the fire show. I've never seen anything like this before. They even told us they were the original fire show on water out of any resort, and it was thoroughly entertaining. I loved this guy blowing fire out of his mouth. The dancers were awesome. The singers were awesome. I did want to mention they do have a really nice gift shop located right beside the lobby. I got a couple t-shirts, a picture frame, some stuff for the kids. Definitely don't forget to bring plenty of sunscreen. We ran out. Had to pay about $30-$40 a bottle. Definitely not fun, but great they have it there for you. And that wraps up our trip. I wanted to mention how we got back to the airport because we did not want to take the shuttle again and risk my husband getting sick before a long travel day, so we took the ferry. Now the ferry ride takes around 1.5 hours to get back to the airport, so you're not really saving much time like you are with the helicopter, but it was so much fun. The workers were fabulous, kept us entertained. You got drinks and snacks. You got to see all the pretty mountains, the Piton Mountains, and just being over the water. Highly, highly recommend doing this, whether you do a helicopter or a boat. We loved them both. Again, the workers are so nice. They offered lots of picture taking for us. So that about wraps up this video. I'm sorry it took a little bit longer compared to my other videos, but there was so much to share about this gorgeous island and sandals and just giving you all the information I possibly can. Would I stay here again? Absolutely. I don't like the pricing. I feel like it could be a little lower, but Sandals did have everything when it came to the pools, the calm beach, and all the amenities I was looking for. So if you made it to this point in the video, thank you so much for watching. Definitely subscribe, and just remember, we can book anywhere you want to go, whether it's international or domestic, cruises, the Caribbean, if you want to go to Greece, all the things we can do for you guys. So definitely hit us up. We try to find the very best prices for you guys. No price gouging, upcharging like some other TAs do. Just a small business that me and my husband have started. You can check out our Facebook page also. We share weekly deals. We also share real client reviews with their photos from their vacations and their feedback. Thank you guys so much for watching this channel and supporting me and my husband and my little family. I hope you guys have a wonderful day and a great week, and I can't wait to share the next video with you.